Hey there once again, YouTube. You know, I already did a video today, but I just wanted to bring this to you real quick. We just had a very, very strong magnitude 5.6 earthquake at 9.4 kilometers in depth, just right on the coast of Northern California near Petrolia, California. Now, this area is no stranger to earthquake activity, but as you'll see in a second, this is the strongest earthquake to hit this area specifically since the year 2000, possibly even before that, but I just looked on the earthquake catalog since the year 2000, January 1st, 2000. And this comes just about 10 hours or so after a pretty strong earthquake swarm along the Bronco fracture zone, just west of the Cascadia subduction zone off the coast of Oregon. We see two earthquakes again were reported for the Cascadia subduction zone itself, occurring most likely during this earthquake swarm right here. Again, my last video that I did earlier today did cover that, but I just want to let you guys know there is definitely a strong earthquake, a nice uptick, maybe nice isn't the correct word, but there's definitely an uptick in seismic activity going on along the west coast today. Yeah, so 5.6 and 9.4 kilometers in depth. Let's check out the event page. Just occurred at, let's see, 3:53 UTC. So that was 8:53 p.m. Pacific time. Right now, as I'm talking to you, is 9:20 p.m. Pacific time, June 22nd, 2019. So it occurred about, I'm going to say, 27 minutes ago or so. So it still is a brand new earthquake. Felt reports are still coming in. 295 people have already reported feeling it in the past 27 minutes. So felt reports are most likely going to come in. I'm feeling this will probably go to maybe 800 felt reports. Let's see, they have the moment tensor and the origin. Notice the origin is automatic, which means a seismologist has not reviewed this earthquake yet. So the magnitude 5.6 and the depth of 9.5 kilometers, it's saying now, is subject to change. It likely will change because computers do get it wrong a lot. There was a tsunami warning for this magnitude 5.6 that just occurred 27 minutes ago, but I do not believe it's going to generate any type of tsunami at all. I could be wrong, but I do not believe it at all. But, you know, it says estimated economic losses and fatalities are in the green, which, yeah, of course, it's a 5.6. It's not going to kill or really damage much. But they do believe there was a limited area affected, little or no population exposed for landslides. That should be in the green, but it's in the yellow. So it is possible there could be some slight damage, maybe some slight cracks in some buildings, but nothing more than that, really. Again, it's magnitude 5.6 and 9.5 kilometers in depth. Let's go to the earthquake catalog, shall we? Now, for this area in Northern California, I have picked magnitude 5.0 and above since January 1st, 2000. So over 19 years worth of seismic data, or seismic data epicenters, or earthquake epicenters. You know what I mean, guys. Sorry, I'm a little tired right now. Was not planning on doing this video. But you can see the largest for this area right here is definitely today's magnitude 5.6 and 9.4 kilometers in depth, or 9.5, whatever you say. Definitely the largest since January 1st, 2000, maybe even prior to that. And over here we had a 5.0 in 2006, and then over here we had a 5.7 in 2015. So again, it does seem that tonight's magnitude 5.6 is the largest for this area right here, unless you go just a few kilometers. Let's see, what is that, 30 kilometers? That's about 30 kilometers away. So if you go 30 kilometers to the west, then yeah, this isn't the largest event, but it's definitely noteworthy, that is for sure. The largest event ever to occur in this area since January 1st, 2000 was, which one was it? Let's scroll all the way down. The magnitude 6.8 at 16.4 kilometers in depth. And in 2014, so 2014, 2015 was definitely a busy year. And let's see, I believe that was the largest. Okay, so it's been a while since we've seen a large earthquake like this. It is no coincidence that it's during the same day that we saw the strong earthquake swarm along the Blanco fracture zone, which included a 5.0, two magnitude 5.4s, and multiple other earthquakes between magnitude 3.0 and 4.5. So I think that's pretty interesting. Now let's go here and see what the closest seismic station is to today's magnitude 5.6. We're going back to the event page. Look at this. It's only been, what, like 10 minutes? It's only been like 5, 10 minutes since I started recording this video. 405 people. It was just at, what, 295 or something like that, just a little bit ago, just a few minutes ago. So we're definitely still seeing a lot of felt reports coming in. It still has not been reviewed by a seismologist, but when it is, the depth and the magnitude probably will change, and the location, the latitude and longitude, probably will change just a little bit, because computers do get it wrong, and they always, earthquakes always need to be reviewed by a seismologist. Always, guys. Always. Again, highly unlikely there's any damage associated to this earthquake, but Let's go to origin, see what the closest seismic station is to this event. Go to phases, quick arrival time once. Notice we have PETL and the BK network, broadband vertical, zero is our location code. We're going to take the data from that and look at it right now, the most recent data stream in the seismic program swarm. Here we are in the seismic program swarm with the most recent data stream as of 9:29 p.m. Pacific time, June 22nd, 2019, from station PETL in the BK network, 00 location code, broadband vertical, HHZ. I did add a 1 Hz high pass filter because this is a broadband channel just to get rid of those pesky background microseisms. But first, before we start, I'm going to turn off the filter. Just with these larger earthquakes, I always like to see what they look like without the filter because sometimes they can have some really strong, really low frequencies, and we do somewhat see that with this earthquake right here. Going forward, going backwards, watch down here. Now, those are the background microseisms from the ocean, which are shown in both volcanic and non-volcanic areas alike with broadband channels. Going forward, watch how it grows. Look at that. Did you see how it pulsed? Did you see that? Here, let me zoom in just a little bit. I think it might show a little better. You see that? Look at that. Isn't that weird? I actually have no clue what that is from. Look at that. Notice right down there, you can see detail. And then right when I get right to the earthquake, boom. And it kind of pulses. You notice that? That is weird. I actually do not know what that's caused by. That could be an artifact from the program itself. I don't know. Still, I think it's very odd. But we did see a magnitude 5.6. At supposedly 9.4 kilometers in depth, but that is still subject to change. Now let's turn on that 1 Hz high pass filter. Notice the background microseisms are basically gone. There's still a little bit left, which is very interesting. Let's check out the dominant frequencies of this quote unquote background tremor. Notice how it ends at about 1.5 Hz. In my opinion, a little too high to be considered microseisms from the ocean. A little bit too high, so I don't know exactly what's going on there. I think that's kind of intriguing, but Here's the magnitude 5.6. Let's zoom in just a little bit. Check out the waveforms. We have wave is slightly emergent, but it looks like it kind of goes down at first, so could be showing dilatation from the station. I know that rhymed. And there's the magnitude 5.6 going forward. We do see multiple aftershocks starting at about, I'm going to say, 2055 Pacific time, June 22nd, 2019. Multiple aftershocks. Keep going forward. You can see a lot of aftershocks related, but I'm guessing they're probably around magnitude 2 to magnitude 3. Let's take a look at this one just real quick. It's kind of stuck in between the surface waves of the earthquake, but going up to about 20,000 amplitude count. Very weird S wave going all the way down to 40,000. That's very, very odd. But I'm going to say, yeah, that's probably about a magnitude 2 to magnitude 3 aftershock right there. Multiple magnitude 1s as well, even a little bit smaller. So definitely seeing a lot of aftershocks, guys. It is still going. Look at all those aftershocks. But they're very small, though, except for this one right here. Now, notice this right here. Let's zoom in on this. This looks kind of interesting. That's very intriguing. Do you see that right there? Here, my bad. Look how the low frequency band below 5 Hz is pretty weak, right? I mean, of course, over here it's pretty strong from the tail, from the surface waves, from the earthquake, lasting quite a while. But notice how it starts to die down, right? Right down here. It starts to die down, gets pretty weak. But then over here, right before this one aftershock, there is some type of low frequency event, in my opinion. Notice that right there. What is that? What is that right there? That's kind of weird. Let's see if I can zoom in. Let's zoom out. My bad. The earthquakes keep getting in the way. I don't know what that is. That could be maybe just background noise. I'm not sure, though. That does look like a low frequency event. Very interesting. Maybe something was opening. I don't know. Because low-frequency events usually signify subsurface movement of magma. And no, low-frequency events does not mean they are deep. For example, there can be a very high-frequency earthquake at 600 kilometers in depth and a very high-frequency earthquake at 1 kilometer in depth. Frequencies simply mean the spacings of the waveforms. For example, let's say it's 0.2 seconds from peak to peak. That would be considered a high-frequency event. let's say it's 5 seconds to 20 seconds from peak to peak of the waveforms. That would be considered a low frequency or an ultra low frequency event, depending on the waveform spacings. Has nothing to do with depth. I don't even know who got that in their mind or even where they heard that from, but nothing could be further from the truth. And shallow low-frequency events should be monitored in volcanic areas. And if you think that low-frequency events are caused by depth, then you're really not going to be monitoring volcanoes correctly, are you? So, I'm just saying that, just putting that out there, because some people have been stating that recently. At least that's what I'm told. At least that's what some people have been telling me lately. And going forward, it looks like the aftershocks are starting to die down as of the most recent data stream. But there still are a few aftershocks. They're definitely still occurring, guys. So, again, magnitude 5.6 at supposedly 9.4 kilometers in depth, but a seismologist has not reviewed it yet. Let's refresh the event page, see if the seismologist has reviewed it yet. By the time this video up, it's possible that they have. Again, the magnitude and depth probably will change. Let's see here. Origin is still automatic, and it's only been a few minutes. Remember how the felt count was 405 just a few minutes ago? Boom! 658. I'm guessing probably over 1,000 people are going to feel this. Let's check out the shake map, which says this earthquake was quite strong. Check out this shake map, guys. Scroll all the way down in the yellow, almost orange. That's very strong. Very, very strong shaking for people who live right on the coast right here. Weak shaking, just a little bit inland, so wasn't too major, but definitely very, very odd. That occurred basically within a 24-hour period of the earthquake swarm along the Blanco fracture zone. So I will definitely keep a closer eye on this. Let's go back to the earthquake map just to see if any other earthquakes anywhere have occurred that I have missed. Again, we see that 5.6, one day all magnitudes. We see the earthquake swarm along the Blanco fracture zone just west of the Cascadia subduction zone. Two earthquakes reported for the zone itself. And let's zoom all the way out to the world. And there's a little, they're reporting one aftershock for, actually wait, that's not an aftershock, just a tiny quake at the Geyser, California. So, I hope you guys stay safe. Let me know if you felt this earthquake in the comment section below. I'll be back. God bless, and always be prepared. Looks like seismic activity could be ramping up for the West Coast, but you never know. We don't know. Sometimes the activity ramps up and then it just drops off. So, we'll see where this is headed. God bless, guys, and have a great night.